sunny day, but boy, those nights are getting chilly. Let's check in with Kris Crocker. Feeling more and more like fall out there, Kris?
Yes, except boy, we did warm up nicely today. Here's a live look over downtown Spokane. I swear every day you can see the change in the trees in this shot. They are changing fast. Fall is just barreling in, even though it didn't feel much like fall today with temperatures in the mid-70s. Tonight, we'll be cooling down into the 40s with partly cloudy skies, northeast winds at 5 to 15 miles per hour. A breezy day tomorrow and a little bit cooler, a high of 71, partly cloudy skies, wind gusts to 25 miles per hour. Those winds will pick up even a little bit more on Saturday. Our high today, 75. 68 is our average high. This is the warmest we've been in almost 3 weeks. 6:37 is our sunset time. It's 75 right now in Spokane. We do have some high clouds over the region. North winds at 11 miles per hour. It's 73 with sunny skies in Coeur d'Alene and northwest winds at 7 miles per hour. Interesting satellite and radar picture here. We've got a big dip in the jet stream plunging into the central part of the United States, where they're going to have some very cold weather ahead the next week. We are on the extreme edge of that cold air, actually sort of sandwiched in between very cold air to our east and above average temperatures to our south and west, with an area of low pressure down here to our south. A Rex block set up here with high pressure off the coast. It isn't going to change much, but enough that we are going to tap into a little bit more of the cool air to our east. As cold fronts make their way down to our east, we will get brushed with increasingly cooler air, cooling things back down to average as we get into the first part of the weekend and then a little bit below. For the most part, this is going to be a dry weather pattern for us, except the possibility of a few mountain showers. We may get a sprinkle or two on Sunday, and we are going to see our winds pick up. Tomorrow's still a little bit above average, then right about average Saturday, a good dip on Sunday, and then we will be seasonable next work week with temperatures in the mid to upper 60s. Overnight lows tonight with a few clouds. We shouldn't see too many cold spots. Will be in the 40s and 50s. High temperatures tomorrow in the 60s and 70s, upper 60s in most locations. 66 in Sandpoint. There is that 80 in Lewiston, 72 in Seattle. Here is your 7-day forecast. Breezy for Friday and Saturday as weak cold fronts make their way down from Canada. We do have a slight chance of showers on Sunday and some cooler weather, but then next week, more pretty fall weather in and out of the clouds. Should be staying dry. We could actually use a little precipitation. I was talking to some farmers' wives out in Davenport yesterday, and they were saying now that the harvest is done and everything is seeded, it is time to bring on the rain. So I will do the best I can, ladies. As a reminder, Coats for Kids is now in full swing.
Yes,
and boy, did it get into full swing yesterday. This is our 34th year bringing the community together to collect, clean, and distribute winter coats to kids who need them. All the coats donated stay in the communities in which they were donated.
Yeah.
And the collection period runs all the way until October 31st. Plenty of time for a complete list of drop-off locations. You can go to our website, KXLY.com. We have about 400 boxes out in the community.
Yeah.
There's one near you.
Kicked it off last night. If you didn't see us on KXLY 4 News at 5 and 6, out in the Spokane Valley at the Albertsons there. What a night you had.
We had a party, marching bands and firefighters from District 8.
Pretty cool.
It was great.
It was.